pair of jeans, a shirt or two. We didn't pack as if we weren't going back. It doesn't matter if it's true. I've got a feeling love will give us what we lack. The world is waiting up. The world is waiting half a step beyond our door. And if it's not enough, I wanna see the stuff the world has got in store. I wanna take it all in, I'm falling. The cityscape by night, wanna catch in my photos. Where you go, every corner twice as bright. There'll be my treasures forever. When I can't hold you tight, I'll see the Stockholm lights. The Stockholm lights, the Stockholm lights. Tomorrow feels a year away, like the seconds, the beginning and the end. But if in time it's yesterday, your picture's gonna bring it home to me again. The world is waiting up. The world is waiting half a step beyond our door. And if it's not enough, I see the stuff the world has got in store. I wanna take it all in, I'm falling. The cityscape by night, wanna catch in my photos. Where you go, every corner twice as bright. There'll be my treasures forever. When I can't hold you tight, I'll see the Stockholm lights. The Stockholm lights, the Stockholm lights.
goes till I get up. Time is barely on our side. I don't wanna waste what's left. The storms we chase are leading us, and love is all we'll ever trust. Yeah, no, I don't wanna waste what's left. And on we'll go, through the wastelands, through the highways, till my shadow turns to sun rays. And on we'll go, through the wastelands, through the highways. And on.
That was Tyler modeling our new merch, which I probably should have looked at closer at. Welcome, everybody. Welcome back to the Odyssey Racing League podcast, episode three of this season. So we are back for another season. We had a little bit of a patchwork team last season, but we really found our rhythm inside of the floor plan of the podcast we were having. So as you know, I'm Abdul. You might know me as Forza Abdul around the server. I'm a league admin, one of the league founders and admins. Tyler is here as well, along with James, who's also a league admin. And then our newest ACC admin, Joel, is here. Many welcomes to Joel for not only coming on to the podcast today, but for joining the admin team. Guys, we have been off for about a couple of weeks. Any quick notes you guys want to say before we launch into things? We do have a lot of exciting announcements.
Is it Joel or Joel?
Yeah, Joel. I say Joel because... Okay. Is it Joel?
Yeah, it's Joel.
Like Billy Joel? Okay.
Exactly.
Okay. Well, there you go. I've been saying Joel's name wrong the whole time.
Okay, it's
language. But it's a language barrier. It is, yes. I'm from Pakistan, you know. Still learning English. We're excited to be back this week because we had the first couple of weeks without the desyncing problem in F1. But we also had some exciting announcements. F1 2022 is going to be out early July, and you could get that 3 days early if you pre-order it with their Masters Edition or whatever their higher-up edition is. F1 Manager is coming out as well, along with the fact that we have announced a couple new ACC races. On Sunday is going to be the GT4 Cup due to popular demand. People really wanted it. And then on Mondays is a permanent mixed class race, which will actually be happening in about 50 minutes or so. And then our Endurance League was a good success on Saturday, so our next Endurance race will be in a couple of weeks. So that's sort of what's been happening in terms of additions to the league. But beyond that, we have started to delve into iRacing group racing, which means we're not hosting a league yet. But we get together, and if you guys are interested in that, hit the rules tab and then hit iRacing. And then whenever we go racing together, I'll ping everyone, or somebody will ping everyone to the group. So that is sort of the recap of what's been going on. Tyler, what are your thoughts on what's been going on, and what is some of the exciting news that we have coming up ahead?
Well, as you can see, the merch just dropped, so that's a really fun thing. We've been working on this for a while now. It's been months and months in the process, so we finally got it dropped. So the it's live, so I'll just go ahead and link the link in the chat. So
did we push an announcement to the Discord yet for it?
I haven't pushed an announcement yet. I want to release it on here first so we can get everyone in the podcast. So So merch is as you can see, Abdul has his hoodie on. Has his hat on. Here's the hoodie.
Trucker hat.
You see, you can get the hoodie custom. You can put your name on the back, and you can put your number on the back. And there's also a hoodie that you can put a flag on their left sleeve, like your country flag.
So I'm wearing the t-shirt,
I have the t-shirt too underneath this, but I don't feel like taking the hoodie off. So yeah, really solid stuff. There's a hoodie that the patches above the left heart, above your heart, and it's the red and white one. So it's definitely a solid merch line. We got a lot of fun stuff in there. It's a bunch of cool stuff.
I really want one of those custom shirts with the you can put your country flag on it. That's cool.
Yeah, so it's a solid solid line for sure. And we'll be doing a giveaway. However, we're gonna be giving away a hoodie, but what I'll say is that it's exclusive to Instagram. So don't forget to go ahead and follow the Instagram. And then we'll be doing, I'll go ahead and tell the other giveaways while we're in here as well. So we're giving away a hoodie. You can choose one of your liking, not a custom one, because they're a little bit more expensive. Well, actually, maybe you can't. Whatever. You choose any hoodie you want, besides the champion one. So yeah, any hoodie you want, you can choose this one. You can get one with your name on the back, et cetera, et cetera. That's exclusive to Instagram, so be sure to be following us on Instagram, and we'll post a giveaway there soon. We'll be doing a Twitter giveaway, which will be the ACC GT4 pack, the DLC, so that's what we'll be doing there. And then in the Discord server, since that's where everyone is, and we're trying to get people to follow the social media, we'll be giving away a hat of your choice, an ORL hat of your choice, inside the Discord. So that's a couple of the giveaways there.
Tyler, question for you in the middle of it. What if an admin was to restrict the Instagram account and be the only like on it?
That would be called rigging the system.
I don't consider it. I consider constructive feedback.
And for everyone that's wondering, it does ship to all over the world. So it'll ship to Philippines, Indonesia, Australia, New Zealand, UK. Fizzy, thank you for the gifted sub, my guy. We appreciate you. So it ships all over the all over the world. It might take a little bit longer to get your stuff. Europe, South America, literally every continent you can think of. But it, like I said, it might take a little bit longer to get your stuff. However, I did put some things in there that are actually made in Europe and then made in the Oceania region. So you can check the shipment times, so to figure out which ones work for you.
That's,
so
That's not to underrate that, because merchandising is, I think we learned a valuable lesson in merchandising over the last couple of weeks.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's very tough to do. It's a lot tougher than you think, even to have a simple t-shirt printed with a single thing on it to be able to ship some people. So we tried our absolute best to put it at a good price point. I can attest to the merch that's that very good quality. This hat is like really nice. And the fact that it ships all over the world at a reasonable shipping cost is, I think, something that very few leagues, if any, do at all.
Yeah, definitely.
It's nice embroidery on the hat, too. It's not just a...
Yeah.
Yep. Yes.
Print.
I've gotten a couple... I pushed this out to a couple people. Joel saw it. Joel got something so far. But like I said, I pushed this out to a couple people that have been in the league for a while and got their opinions on it. One of the questions I got was embroidery stuff. All embroidered stuff is going to be just that white logo, just for the pure fact that it's $6.50 every time we even change the size by an inch. So if we change the colors and we have more thread colors in it, it gets just really pricey. So for now, it'll be just the white embroidery logo on all the stuff that is embroidered. Like I was telling you before, the custom hoodie, you can put your last name and number on the back, and then there's also one with your country flag if you want to do that as well. Basically what you do is you get to the website, you hit personalize your design, and then you can go and put in any PNG you want to. So it doesn't even have to be a country flag. Joel was talking about putting his livery of the car that he drives in ACC and on the sleeve. So a different look at it. Definitely a cool one.
Let me just mention real quick, cause I was messing around with it. And if you click personalized design without selecting a color or a size,
right,
it will come up with an error. So make sure you select those.
Correct. Yes. Pokerano said you can put Abdul's face on it. Yeah, you can put it.
Damn right.
You could literally put whatever you want.
Yeah, damn fucking right. Pokerano, if you do that, I will wear that shit.
So definitely a fun time here for the league. A lot of cool things going on. As you saw, Matt put out an announcement about the VR role. We'll be doing a lot of VR stuff. So if you have VR and want to, you know, race in VR and whatnot, be sure to go to the roles tab under information. No, getting started. Under the getting started category to choose your VR role. Another thing, as you saw, again, I'll say, I know I said in the server a couple times, but big shout out to Guac, one of our admins. It's his 18th birthday, so happy birthday, brother. We appreciate what you do. And that being said, I'll go off the back of that and say, you guys get a birthday roll if it's your birthday, and you're above like everyone in the server as far as roles go. So it's pretty cool. It's you're recognized. We want to show you guys love and show you guys that. Your birthday's very much valued. So be sure to use the command. You can use the command. It's /set-birthday. Just anywhere in the server. And it'll set that. Hey, my dad just followed us. Hey, Dad.
Tony! That's awesome.
So, yeah, definitely. Yeah, the big 1-8 for Guac today. So be sure to put your birthday in there so we can show you guys love. A couple other things. I'll go ahead and let Abdul talk on partnerships. So if you want to take away that, you and James want to team that up.
Yeah, so I would consider when we were thinking about the different ways to help people get involved in the league. And there has been people who sort of come forward and say, well, how can I be a bigger part of the league? And obviously we do need the help in terms of manpower, but you can see some of the brilliant admins and moderators we have coming on. But the other part of it is it's an expensive league to run. I can say this with a confident fact that we have not made a single dollar profit all of these months.
We've made negative.
And we're in the black, and that's okay. That's not a problem. We're not in this to really make a large profit. That being said, if you guys contribute through your subs, you guys contribute through your merch drops as well. But if you do want to become a bigger part of this league and want your opinion to come straight to the moderators, again, we value everyone's opinions, but if you sign up for an ORL membership. And I believe it's only $5 a month, Tyler?
Yeah, it's just $5. There's links in the chat.
Right. It's relatively cheap. It's the same price of a sub. And that way you can get a direct line to us, give us suggestions. We've gotten really good suggestions from that group, as well as some additional benefits as well. So that's how we get the feedback from people, and that's how you can contribute to the league apart from being involved in sort of the operations, because not everyone has the time to do it, but they want to be able to contribute and show appreciation to their league, which is us, Odyssey Racing League, and that's one of the ways of doing it. James, do you think of anything else on top of your head?
I just mentioned that it's the same price as a Twitch sub, but we also do get a much larger cut from those memberships than we do from Twitch.
Yep.
Because Twitch takes about half.
Yeah. And then, Abdul, if you want to touch on the partnerships that we have so far and what we're working on currently, so we can let them get in the loop.
Yeah, absolutely. So you guys know about, and you're going to have to tell me, I forgot the name of the third one, but we have Track Titan, who's, we've actually done a really good job with. We have a decent amount of people on Track Titan, and then Rogue Energy as well. It's a little bit more of a steady stream of people coming into there. But those are our two partners. We have a third partner, which is Esports Furniture, Tyler?
Yep. Mm-hmm. It's like
Esports Furniture.
Yeah, it's like gaming chairs. You can get keyboards, mouses, desks.
And tables, and all sorts of stuff.
Right.
And but I'm very appreciative of that. It's because that one I particularly like, especially since we're going to be needing a new desk very soon, because it's stuff that's actually made and geared towards gamers. So, you know, the table that you're about to buy is not like an office table that was like retrofitted as
James.
A gaming table.
Hmm?
James.
Oh.
James with the white table.
Yes,
the beer pong. Yeah, James with the beer pong table. In fact, things that actually make sense. Gaming chairs are nice for being able to sit for because we do race or we talk for long periods of time. And then the tables make sense. Instead of buying an office chair and then trying to retrofit it to your sim racing gear, as I have can attest to the last few years, is very difficult and a lot more than you think. So that's our third partner. And then beyond that, we are in contact with other people. Don't want to say specific names yet, but we are in contact with a few other sponsors of the league as well.
Fantech.
There's the benefits of this is tenfold. First of all, the fact is that it brings investment into the league. Again, this is not anything that we make money off of, but it gives us investment to be able to create merch or more put more time into the league or to be able to create more products for the league. Secondly, it gives you guys a way to get a little bit of a discount on these things because a lot of you guys use this stuff anyway. So by us being involved, giving credibility to our league, and then you guys are getting a little bit of a discount back on the other end, it's mutually beneficial to all of us. That being said, not every sponsorship is going to work. That being said, I'm very blessed to say every sponsorship for us has worked so far. Not every sponsorship is going to work. So it's important to get your feedback. What did you like? Did you like the product? Were you treated well? What's the discount? Whatever it is. So that's what we're sort of considering right now for partnerships. And then we hope to be able to expand on that in the coming future.
Yeah, definitely.
We have a new follower. I just can't tell.
Kelrin, thank you for the follow. Also, guys, there's a poll right now. It's between the hoodie and the hat. Which one do you like more of the merch so far?
If you guys say the hat is not cooler, first of all, I'm going to take this off and show you. This is a trucker hat, okay? I got this because I'm so southern that it's like, it's hard to see.
Right, brother, right.
Literally a trucker hat. And I did like the idea of a 5-panel hat as well. I feel as with the trucker hat that I can really show my southern pride from my experience in American Truck Simulator. That'd be very disheartening if you don't vote for the hat. Thank you, Kim.
So next thing what I want to do is I want to get Joel on the mic here since we've been talking a little bit and kind of have him discuss since he's entered the league, kind of what how it's evolved and his thoughts on, you know, all the big announcements that have been here and, you know, et cetera, et cetera.
Hello. I'm super pleased with how things have evolved. so quickly, just since I've been here in the past, I don't even know, 3 months. With you know, the amount of people we have in the league and just how helpful everybody is, I know I've learned a lot, and I do my best to help other people learn a lot. Just become better racers at the end of the day. And it's really like we're a big family, to be honest with you. Super thrilled, and I'm definitely grateful to be brought on the admin team.
Absolutely.
Oh, we're excited to have you, Joel.
Thank you, Forza, for gifting my father a sub. Dad,
Tony my dad as well. So
I put the link to how to purchase our merchandise in the chat, Dad.
Fun fact, I send Tony candy every month.
Well, he sends it to me, but my dad eats it, but that's okay. Yeah. definitely excited to have Joel on the team. Definitely a good brain to pick as far as ACC goes. Very talented driver, just a well-spoken individual. So we're excited to have him on the team.
And he's from
New
Orleans.
Making me blush.
And he was also a big, big help in the merch category as well. We stayed up till a long time the other night and worked on it. So we appreciate you.
Yeah. This is very true.
I appreciate y'all.
So
we need a face reveal now.
So he's getting his cam.
Face reveal.
Dude, send me a cam and I'll happily plug it in.
So going off the back of that, Forza, if you want to talk about the new staff on board and, you know, how we're growing and the constant need for more staff as well. So,
yeah, I think this is something that was funny. I think Fizzy, one of our league founders, brought it up about a month and a half ago, and it said something to the fact of, and at that time I thought the staff had been sort of large enough, and he said something to the effect of, we're going to need a lot more staff. And I thought to myself, well, that I don't know about that. You know, I was like, I don't know if we need more staff. Because, again, we had our hands on everything, and managing staff in itself is a challenge that I bet every single one of these league admins can attest to. But we need more staff, and that's become readily apparent to me in a matter of weeks, the amount of work that goes into our league, because we have to have people who are hosting above 10 divisions now in the league, not counting the iRacing, that's stuff that we're looking to get into. These are people who host, do standings, are stewards, and do incident reports and all sorts of stuff. And that's just the racing in itself. And then we have staff who works on merch. The other side of it, doing these podcasts and hosting as well and commentating. It's a lot of work. I'm very blessed to say that our staff has done a spectacular job so far. And we have all our bases covered. That being said, we just have our bases covered. And if you are at all interested in being involved in any part of our league, say, I just want to do only stewarding. Well, that's fine, because we do need stewards. I just want to do commentating, or whatever it is. If you are at all interested in being on our staff, there's always an area for you to help out on. I'm very sad the ORL hoodie won, but I'm going to skip over that. say this league has grown, and I will say this, and I say it all the time, this league has grown for a lot, way bigger than we initially thought it was. It was like 20 people in the league before when Tyler and Fizzy created this. It was a full throttle racing league like 3 or 4 months ago. And it was just a league for their subscribers, and now it's this crazy thing where we have merch and memberships and all sorts of stuff for the league. Tony Cahigas says, of course I am, and the ladies love me. Thank you, Tony. And the staffing part of it is important, that we not only we need new staff, but we need people to be involved in different areas of it. And I can happily say Joel is one of our ACC admins, but we do have other admins who have come on board as well and who play a crucial role in our league. And as we sort of grow to that next phase, that second tier, of we're going from just a fun racing league where we had one ACC division, two F1 divisions, and become this sort of mega league. And we are always looking for people on staff and good people on staff. And if you need any at any point to learn to be able to do that stuff, we're happy to be able to teach you. We just need the participation part of it.
Yeah, we're currently at 12 staff members right now, so definitely a big...
Yeah, always could use more.
Yeah, big... big...
There's
the
face reveal.
Hey, Dad.
What's good?
I can see why he's the ladies' man.
All right. Thanks for the face reveal.
Thanks for subbing.
That's hilarious.
We'll send you the first ORL crop top.
So, yeah, we definitely are in the... looking for more staff. Definitely excited about the future of the league.
That's the best moment that's ever happened to our podcast. Holy shit.
Someone clip that.
Please.
We'll let... I'll let Joel and James actually kind of tag team this one. Let's talk about the growth of ACC if you want to... Joel, if you want to start, just kick us off, and then James, you can finish that on off.
Just since I've been here, I started with three races left last season. And then, you know, just since this season two has started, we've added, a second tier to the Thursday races. We have mixed class Mondays, and now we're getting ready to kick off GT4 Sundays. You know, I'm hoping by season three, we'll have a couple more divisions to race in, and it's looking like that is highly likely.
Maybe some cup car Saturdays one day. Suggestions?
Don't tease me.
Oh, we do have endurance league.
Spread the word.
James, how do you feel about the growth since you've been here since the very beginning of it?
I mean honestly, I gotta say that, you know, I was apprehensive about ACC. Took Fizzy like probably a month of, you know,
I dragged you guys in.
Dragging me to play the game because I didn't feel like I would enjoy the ACC cars having come from F1. But I have to admit that ACC probably is what has grown this league the most.
Oh, yeah.
I feel like that's pretty clear. I mean, one day, what was it? One day we had like what?
I actually went back and looked at the announcement that I made, and we went from 148 to 340 in like 24 hours.
Right. Wow. So ACC doubled our server members in one day, and has continued to sustain. So, it's just ACC has definitely done a lot better than I would have expected, and I've come to love it more than, well, you know. I won't get into the F1 2021 game, but I'm enjoying ACC a lot more than that.
Yeah.
At the moment.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. It's go ahead, Joel.
I agree. So I came here from playing F1 21. You know, it was just me and my cousin, mainly just goofing off. And then another buddy told me about ACC. And since my very first lap in this game, I've never looked back at F1. It's just unreal. I can't think of a word to describe it, really.
Yeah, it's definitely a fun game. I love commentating for you guys in it. It's slower paced than F1, so I get to like talk to chat and like do the same thing at the same time. So that's definitely a good thing for me.
I do want to highlight a comment.
Don't you dare. Okay.
Oh no. I do see that one too. Avex Bullet says Joel sounds like he's being Joel. Held hostage. Is this true, Joel?
Are you being held hostage? I can neither confirm nor deny.
This just in, Joel being held hostage.
So,
and Rago says James is trash.
You bastard.
Damn.
Sorry.
So,
it's a slander.
Slander, absolute slander. Going off the back of ACC, and I'll go ahead and bring us into the F1 game, not 2021, but 2022. Obviously, that releases June 28th for the people that pre-ordered it with the Champions Edition, and then July 1st for people that didn't. Knowing that, obviously, there's going to be people that have been interested in F1 and are just waiting for the new game to drop, like in America, for example, because F1's gotten very popular. IRL F1's gotten very popular. So with that, I'm assuming that there's going to be a huge influx, and we're going to push the league really hard in like Discord and all other Discords and stuff like that. So we'll get a huge influx of drivers when that game drops. So it should be a good time coming around, you know, around late June, early July for the growing of the Discord. So we're gonna try and use the newness of the game to gain the members, you know. So it's gonna be cool for that. Other than that, one more thing. So currently we are at 464 members. Once we get to 500, we can apply for partnership through Discord. So basically what that is in a nutshell, it is you can personalize your server with a custom URL, so it doesn't have to be
it's like a Twitch subscription for Discord.
Right. Well, no, this is the partner program. So like this is where you can like personalize your server, so like it's a custom URL, so it's not just discord.gg/ you know, so and so.
You're talking about that other thing.
Yeah, so server banner, you can get, you know, get Discord Nitro rewards for your community and access to partner only server. You know, we have a special badge, et cetera, et cetera. So that's all we need left is 500. So what, 300 and there are 36 left, 36 members left. So once we get that, we'll get that. And that'll be cool too, as well, moving forward. I have completely disregarded the topics. So, recap of Australia. F1 2021 is horrible. All right, that's done for that one. All right, IRL F1. we'll just skip to the topic two. Forza, go ahead and take this one away on real F1.
So I guess it's been more of the same. I'm obviously a Mercedes fan. Let me switch hats real quick. I'm obviously a Mercedes fan, and it has not been the best of time this late so far into the season. Mercedes looked decent in Australia. The car looked fine. Purposing looked a little bit better. But still, the car's pace just really wasn't there. And I don't really know what to say. George Russell's doing a very good job. People sort of have been trying to imply that Hamilton's washed, which I think is very funny. But also a little bit reminiscent of what happened to Vettel, so I'm a little bit scared as well. So,
It's been a little iffy.
James, we'll give you a Red Bull spotlight. All right, damn it.
No. It's not a Red Bull spotlight.
Okay.
Let me tell you guys about the curse that is the Leclerc Monaco curse.
Oh, my gosh.
So, in 2017, he took part in the F2 feature race. DNF'd due to a suspension failure. 2017 F2 sprint race. DNF'd due to a electrical failure. 2018 F1 race, his first race in F1 in Monaco. Had a brake failure. 2019 F1 quali. They had a strategy fail. Fucked them over. 2019 F1 race. Had collision damage. 2021 F1 quali. Crashed. Which caused him for the 2021 F1 race to have a drive shaft failure. And then, what was it, a few days ago? He took part in a 2022 historic demo run. Running Niki Lauda's legendary Ferrari F1 car. And had a brake failure and damaged the car. So he is yet to finish. I'm pretty sure he's yet to finish a Monaco race since he was even in F2.
And he's from Monaco, which makes it even worse.
He's the only Monegasque driver. So it hurts. But it's so funny at the same time. Hey, maybe now that, you know, he did the worst thing possible, which is damage a historic F1 car. Not his fault, let me say. But most of those things weren't his fault. But maybe now that he's done that, in the actual Monaco race, he'll finish.
I mean, if he DNFs this year, I don't know what to say. Truly.
He did something. But I just thought I'd bring that up just because I saw it and I was like, it's astounding.
It truly is. That is absolutely incredible.
2017 to 2022, failures in every race.
What's up, Wolf? Wolf, my dad's in the chat. Say what's up to him. So yeah, it's been an interesting season. I think it's been a pretty fun season, to be honest with you. And with Spain coming up, it's gonna be an interesting race there, because you know, I don't think did they change oh, that guys, chicane?
I don't remember, but I hope they did.
In Spa? I think they did.
No, Spain.
Oh, Spain.
I'm hearing, or I saw that Aston Martin is bringing a B car. So like a majorly visually looking different car.
Huh.
But they only have one of them. And, you know, of course, let's not give it to the four-time world champion. Let's give it to Stroll. So Vettel will be running the old spec car.
Interesting.
But yeah.
That.
So hopefully that car will be much better for Aston Martin, because they've been looking
right.
Rough.
Right. Yeah, I'm interested for Spain. I've always liked Spain as a track. Like it just the not the passing obviously, but the layout of it. It's a cool track. And then we go to Monaco. I mean,
yeah. There's a reason why Spain was used for F1 testing track the longest time, because there's
right.
so many variations of corners in it.
Right. Yeah. But yeah, overall pretty good season so far, I think, at least.
Yeah, I've been loving it. I mean, Mercedes hasn't won a race, so I mean, you can't. Which, speaking of, did you know that Mercedes has gotten pole position since 2013 every race at Spain?
Have they?
Yep.
Interesting.
So, the streak might be broken.
At every track, they're like, guess when's the last time Mercedes didn't have a pole at Australia? And then the same thing at like every other track. And I'm like, yeah, well, you know, this is kind of like what's going to happen this season.
I know, every track we get to, it's like
Mercedes caught the last 7 out of 8 poles. That's
right. Yeah, we got to keep rubbing it in.
Yeah. I don't think it's constructive at this point.
They had a decade of being the best. They can handle this. If they can't, they don't deserve
it. I can't handle it, James. It's bad for my mental health. I
can't handle the truth.
You know what? I have to wake up, and I have to wake up at 8 a.m. to watch Lewis Hamilton get stuck behind fucking Pierre Gasly or Lance Stroll all race. It's not good.
Yeah, and I wake up bricked up, okay, because I know that I'm going to see Lewis Hamilton not on the podium.
Yeah, I mean, there's a good chance we won't see Max on the podium either with that reliability.
Hey, how many races has Hamilton won this season?
He has won my heart. He has won my heart.
That's hilarious.
Right.
So, starting at 10 is the Mixed Class Monday for ACC, so we're going to wrap this up in about 5 minutes. I want to get the last 5 minutes before we wrap everything up. I'll say, if for anyone that didn't hear, we're doing an Instagram exclusive giveaway on our Instagram for an ORL hoodie. Our Twitter will be doing an exclusive giveaway to the ACC GT4 pack, the DLC. And then in the server, we'll be giving away an ORL hat. So be sure to be following all the social media channels. Last 5 minutes, I'll go ahead and hand it over to Joel and have him talk about the race quality so far of Tier 1 and ACC from the season so far, and the tracks and how you liked it and et cetera.
The competition in Tier 1, I think it was last week, from P1 to P10, qualifying time was in, within 6/10 or 7/10 of a second of each other, and that was at, was that Silverstone?
Sounds what, right. Last race?
Yes.
Yeah.
And, you know, just the respect all these drivers have for each other. In these races, you know, nobody's dive bombing, nobody's, you know, sticking their nose in on a corner that shouldn't be, you know, shouldn't be trying to make a pass on. And that right there just makes me appreciate what we have going so much more than, you know, just going into an open lobby and racing. And the knowledge everybody has. Most people have for this game, and you know, okay, my car is doing this, how do I fix it, or something of the like, and nobody's afraid to share any wisdom, and I also very much enjoy that about what we have going on here.
Yeah, it's definitely it's fun to watch.
That race, I made a very professional and pro move. Long-time experienced ACC driver. I ran out of fuel.
For everyone in chat, if you guys couldn't tell, James loves to pat himself on the back. You know, we don't do we us league admins.
I literally just said that I ran out of fuel.
Us league admins, we don't pat him on the back enough.
I know what's wrong with it. Patting myself on the back. Okay.
What a shitter,
James. I know what's wrong with it.
Ain't got no gas.
Exactly. Multiple times. I feel like this happened to you multiple times, right?
No, I've ran out of gas. Well, I was low on fuel on F1, I think once, and that gave me PTSD. But then this was the first time in ACC that I've run out of fuel. It was because I was battling somebody. I was trying to catch them.
Do you remember when I ran out of fuel in Zandervoort last season? And yes. I said, James, I think I'm going to run out of fuel.
It's pain.
So everyone, the big announcement. ORL merch, go check it out. I'm going to spam the link in the Discord, or in the Discord, in the chat. Please be sure to go check it out. It's really solid, good quality stuff, actually, to be fair. And there's a lot of options, you know, women's clothes, men's clothes. You know, you got your hats, accessories, etc., phone cases, the whole nine. So go ahead and order that and get that ordered. Yeah, and then, you know, future down the road, you know, probably, I don't know, in a month or so, we'll, you know, giveaways will include, you know, discount codes and stuff like that for you guys. So yeah. Other than that, ACC race in 16 minutes. We'll be live in 16 minutes. I'll end this stream and then start back up another one immediately right after. So be sure to tune in for that. We appreciate you guys all. No Wolf, that's my father. We appreciate you guys all tuning in, and I'll let Forza close us out today.
Yes, brothers, we'll see you again in a couple of weeks, inshallah, as we look to continue our ORL podcast. James got that one. Our podcast is back in a couple of weeks again. Thank you for Joel for coming on the podcast this week. We'll have a new guest on in a couple of weeks. And then we'll get ever so closer to the F1 game. We'll have a little bit of additional developments, update regarding merch and general happenings of the league. And then we'll have the successful launch of the GT4 League, and we'll be coming up on our next endurance race. So just a few things to look forward to. Once again, thank you for tuning in this week. As Tyler said, in a few moments, the Twitch channel will come back up for the Mixed Class Mondays, and we hope that you all tune in for that and all of the races this week. So on behalf of myself and the podcast team, thank you, everybody, and we will see you again very soon.
See you in a bit.
Turn us to thousands, and we'll grow.